ocean receding, they followed the animals and went right up the mountain. The tourists who were there, the European tourists, oh, that was great fun for them. They began to run out, chase the ocean receding. And then, boom, the tsunami came. Over 4,000 of them, it went away, you see. So what humanity has to begin to realize is this thing about looking at the African race as if we are the worst of all humanity, as if we are the dumbest of the dumb of all humanity. It is ridiculous. You've got to come back to us. You've got to kneel down to the African and tell the African, you know what, it's time for you to take over this planet. We have messed up. We can't do anything about it anymore. Our formulas don't work. Our technologies have destroyed it. And you know, brother, let me reiterate this, because it's happening soon.
Please.
The era of Aquarius is less than 100 years from now. Aquarius is here. And before this era comes into place, the Dogon gave a prediction in 1992. 1992 was the last time that they performed the Dogon Sigi ceremony. This ceremony is in alliance with the two stars, Series A and Series B. The trajectory of these two stars is one in which Series B has complete dominance over Series A, although Series B is the smallest, the tiniest of the two stars. Of course, there are other stars around that Orion belt, but let's just focus on Series A and Series B. Series B controls how Series A moves. And it does that by different forces. Now, we can talk about centrifugal forces, centripetal forces, gravitational forces, and levitation forces. It depends on the trajectory that they are taking. So what happens is that when Series B creates a greater pressure within its core, inside the core, then it attracts Series A towards it. So as they keep moving, and then it attracts Series A, this is when they almost come and into each other's paths. But what happens is that as they begin to get closer, Series B releases the forces slowly. And so as it releases the forces, then Series A moves a lot faster, so they don't collide. So it's almost like really a very, very complex intelligence that goes on between these two stars. And so as they move like that in that trajectory, which is an elliptical trajectory, they form what the Dogon call the power of eight. And what did the Dogon do? The Dogon have a base eight mathematics, base eight arithmetic. So everything that the Dogon have done, they have done based on the universe. And that's a fact. There's no theory about the Dogon. There is no philosophy about the Dogon. This is what really gets to me, because when these Europeans go to Bali, they come out, they say Dogon philosophy, rubbish. Everything these people are giving you are all facts. The trajectory of the three stars is eight. You have base eight arithmetic. The Dogon created base eight arithmetic. Now let's go back to the Vai, brother. Let me bring you back to the Vai.
Please.
Now when these brothers traveled across the Pacific Ocean, they found themselves here in the Americas, Central America. Well, what did the Vai do? The Vai said, well, we were building pyramids in Kemet. Why can't we build pyramids here in America too? Why can't we reinforce our presence on this continent that we were here also? That's what they did. So they built the pyramids here in the Americas. And then, brother, what they did was they established, their own medunero is also established. They established the base 20 mathematics. And with the base 20 mathematics, they were also studying the stars. And so, you can identify the Vai with the Omeg. They are who they call the Omeg. You look at the Omeg head, you see that African face right there. So the Omegs are the ones that established the civilization of the Americas, the first civilization. By the way, that civilization lasted for over 2,000 years. And then the Mayan came, or the Aztecs, whichever came. You know, I don't really care to follow who came next. But anyway, the Mayan then began to study the Vai mathematics. the VI established a base 20 mathematics. We, you know, is the one that they were able to study the stars from the Americas here. So with the base 20 mathematics, what's so interesting about this base 20 mathematics is that from the base 20 mathematics, after you keep on counting base 20 numbers, of course, we can't go into that. It's extremely, extremely complex. Even modern mathematicians have a problem with the base 20 mathematics in terms of how you explain it when it really advances further and further. But what happens is that as you advance in base 20 mathematics, you end up, brother, with a binary mathematics, the 0 and the 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. And what do you get from the 0, 1, brother? You get your computer logic.
Wow.
So we were doing this stuff hundreds and hundreds of years ago, thousands of years ago. And let me come back here, brother. You know, hey, brother, you got to slow me down.
Oh, no, but keep going, teacher.
Right,
that's
okay,
what we're here for.
All right, okay. You know, I mean, I enjoy it, brother. I'm enjoying it. So I'm glad that you're giving me all the time to do it.
But oh, yes.
That's great. So let me just come back here to America. Here, in the 1690s, when my great-great-grandfather was teaching at the Dogon University, Timbuktu, the universities of Timbuktu. This is when they capture the prince called Banake. Banake was supposed to become the next emperor of the Mali Songhai Empire. Banake was captured by the French or the Portuguese, whoever they were. Brought that prince over here to the Americas. The brother was the saddest of all the slaves. He was so sad. The brother was the saddest of all the slaves they brought here because he kept remembering about the honor he would have had as the emperor. All the wealth he left behind there, all the powers he left behind there, and was locked in the cabins of slave ships. You can read about it. Eventually, a British woman who was also something servant, indentured servant also, you know, she came from England, and of course she was working for some other slave master, but because she was white, she was freed and she was given land, and so she went to look for a slave to come and work on the land. So she went and got Banake. So Banake came, and then with two other slaves, I think. But what the story says is that Banake was just not interested in doing anything at all. He just didn't do. But this is one thing that he did. He was one that was doing the water channeling into the farm that they were saying. So in effect, where this lady made her farm became the most prosperous of all the farms in that area. I don't know whether it was in Virginia or somewhere. But anyway, that's what the story says, that Banake, because of Banake, this lady's farm was so productive that she was able to get, you know, to do many, many things because it was very profitable for her. So they had, I think, two children or so, two girls or so. And then they went back and got another slave who came and married one of the girls. And then they had Benjamin Banneker. So Benjamin Banneker, then because the father died in an early age, Banneke died earlier because of all the depression, the trauma. You know, I mean, we've been full of trauma, you know, so it's nothing new to us at all. So because Mr. Banake died earlier, he wasn't able to teach Benjamin much. But what he did was, this white woman was so loyal to him. You see, this is the other thing that people need to realize, that sometimes you can have a white person or another race that you interact with that will really be very useful. You see, I mean, so that when we talk about these racial interactions, we have to be able to not just enter it from a point of hate, but we have to enter it from a point of the acceptance, the understanding that exists. And so certainly there are some people who just won't have the understanding. There are some people who have that supremacist kind of tendency to look at everything and say, I'm not going to go there. But then there are some who will say, okay, look, even though my race is doing so and so and so, I am not into that. I am not that kind of a supremacist kind of person, but I'm coming here, I'm going to humble myself to get what is in there for me. So this woman humbled herself, even during the days of slavery. She was very humble to Mr. Banake. And so Banake began to teach her, the basically the connection between the stars and agriculture, the connection between the stars and what you did to make your